Hi everyone, this is Yana Smakula for Pretty Pink Posh. Thanks for joining me. In this video, I'm featuring the Anemone stamp set and coordinating dies and showing how to use dark background colors to help the white images pop on your cards. Anemones come in several colors, but white anemones are probably the most beautiful of all. While white seems a very easy color to work with, it's actually the hardest one to color on paper, especially if everything else you have happening on your project is white. Today, I will show you how you can use a dark background to help these white flowers come to life with minimum and very quick coloring. I'll show you two ways to do this technique. One features a one-layer card and masking, and another card, in case you're not into masking, features some die-cutting and layering. To help myself get started, I created a cheat sheet. I stamped my idea out onto some printer paper. I did so to test my idea and see if it would look good in the end. And I often do this sort of initial stamping on printer paper and not my good white paper to actually save my good white paper. As you can see from this floral frame, I also used masks. I made masks for my flowers using masking paper. Masking is not really my favorite thing to do, but it does allow you to do a lot more for your handmade cards, especially if you don't have coordinating dies or if you prefer to make one layer flat cards. At the same time, I did some color study here. I stamped several images on my good white paper, the kind that I usually use for my cards, and I tested several colors of Copic markers. That especially applies to coloring the flower petals. And I also tested coloring the background, and you can see parts of the paper colored blue next to the leaf and a little bit next to the flower. Having a dark background can really help any one single object come to life. Dark backgrounds really emphasize and draw the eye of the person viewing it to the focal point. Let's get started. I'm going to go ahead and stamp the flowers on a panel of Nina Solar White cardstock to create a floral frame for my card. I'm using my test sheet as a guide. I'm not following it to the letter, I'm just loosely following it. Next, I'm going to mask the flowers, especially the two flowers next to each other, and we'll stamp the leaves in between the floral gaps. If you wanted to follow your test sheet to the letter, you can always do so with the help of a stamping tool. By placing the practice sheet into a misty, for example, aligning the stamp over the initial stamping, removing the cheat sheet, and stamping onto your project. My stamped floral panel is done. I can remove the mask and move on to coloring. I'm going to quickly and loosely color my images using my selected Copic marker colors. I'm using G94, YG63, and G21 to color leaves. This is a nice muted green combo that looks very similar to the anemone's leaves you'd see in real life. To color flower centers, I'm using B99 and B21. I'm first using the dark blue to color almost the entire center, and next filling the highlight in and going over the dark blue coloring with a B21. This causes the ink to lighten, and it creates an easily achievable dome-looking coloring. Finally, to add shading to the flower petals, I am using W1 and B000 colors. I want to add just hints of shadows here where the petals overlap and meet. I want to keep my flowers white, but with a white object, just like with any other object, you always have shadows and highlights. So you must darken some areas of the petals to add shadows and help your flowers look dimensional and not just flat. Coloring white is very hard to do. This is something I am yet to master, but here you don't have to be a pro at coloring white objects, as we will add a blue background and our white images will come to life with very little effort and just minimal shading. Now, the reason I'm coloring with a W1 and also B000 marker is the B000 marker adds just a little tint of blue, and I want my flowers to reflect the background just a little bit. Now that all of the images are colored, I'm going to use a B99 Copic marker and color the entire background. You can see I'm actually matching the color of the background to the flower centers. Think of this as coloring the negative space. We did not spend much time coloring the actual images. Instead, we're coloring the background here. It does take time to apply all of that color, especially next to the stamped images, as you need to go slow and be patient, but it really does look phenomenal in the end. This does take a lot of ink from your marker, so if this is not something you'd like to do, especially considering how expensive Copic markers are, I do have another simplified idea in this video, so keep watching. Once my background coloring was finished, I left my color panel to dry for about 10 minutes, and then I came back and white heat embossed the sentiment. You can use any sentiment you like for this project. It can easily be a birthday card, a friendship card, an apology card, a congratulations card, anything you want it to be. I'm making this into a happy mail card by heat embossing, sending you happy mail sentiment from the Happy Mail stamp set from Pretty Pink Posh. I adhered my background onto an A2 white top folding card base, and to dress this card up, I decided to use gold confetti and clear jewels. I really couldn't decide which of these embellishments I wanted to use because I love both of them. So I used both by first adhering the confetti piece and topping it with a jewel, with a clear sparkling jewel of the exact same size. This created just the perfect gold accents for this project. Like I mentioned, not everyone wants to use their Copic markers to color the background around the images, as that takes a ton of ink and this is also time consuming. So another way to go about this is to add your die-cut images onto a background made out of colored cardstock. Here I stamped several images I want to use for my second card, and I'm loosely coloring them using the same colors of markers as before. Now I'm not being careful here, and I just quickly color these, and I'm not even staying within the lines. I don't need to do that, and you will understand why in just a minute. I used coordinating dies from Pretty Pink Posh, and I cut these out in my die-cutting machine. This gave me beautiful stamped, colored, and die-cut pieces for my card. Now, this also gave me a white outline to each of my die-cuts. It's going to be very distracting for the project and the effect that I have in mind. So I'm using a Copic marker once again, and I'm color matching that white outline to the background color. It's still the same deep blue. It's my favorite color lately. So again, I'm using B99 marker for this, the same one as I used for the first card. So here, instead of coloring the entire background, I'm replacing the marker-colored background with colored cardstock and only coloring the white die-cut outlines on my stamped images. When you bring these images on white paper, they look very odd, and you can see that here. But when you take them to a same color background, they look completely different, and they give your project a very different end result. They blend with the background, and they become one. They look as if they were done on the background directly, and they don't have that white border that separates them from the base. This is not a trick that will work for every card design or every image, but this is very fitting for these gorgeous white anemones. Here are the two cards side by side, one with a Copic colored background and the second one with a colored cardstock and just the colored borders. I went with Life is Better with You sentiment for my second project. This one comes from the Thoughtful Greetings stamp set from Pretty Pink Posh, and I also embellished this card using clear jewels. I adhered them using glue, and they look white on video as the glue was still wet. Here is a closer look at these cards created with the Anemones stamp set from Pretty Pink Posh. I hope you feel inspired to create. If you make something inspired by this video, we'd love to see it. Be sure to share it on social media and tag us. Thanks so much for watching this video. If you have any questions, as always, leave me a comment below. Thank you, and I'll see you next time. Bye!